Good morning, children. In last class, we learned what is a decimal, how to write the expanded form, place values, like, unlike decimals, and all, right? So, in today's session, we are going to start exercise 7.1. Come on. Here, the first question is write the expanded form. Expanded form also we discussed in the last class, right? Expanded form is nothing but if we write the place value of each digit and then put plus between them, that is expanded form, right? See, first here itself, let us specify the place values. Before decimal point, this is integral part. In integral part, normal place values only, ones, tens, hundreds, and so on. In the decimal part, the place values are tens, hundreds, thousands, right? Now, what is the place value of 2? 2 is in tens place, so its place value is 20 plus. 1 is in 1's place. So, place value of 1 is 1 only. Here children, when we have zeros, if you want we can write, otherwise we can avoid also. If you want how to write 0 in 10's place. So, 0 by 10 and then 0 by 100 and then 5 by 1000. Okay? 0 by 10, 0 by 100, 5 by 1000. But when we have zeros, we can avoid them. No need to write. Okay? So, 5 is in thousands place. So, 5 by 1000. This is fractional expansion. Now, let us write decimal expansion also. In fractional expansion or decimal expansion, whole part never change. So, 20 plus 1 we have to write as it is. 20 plus 1. Now, 5 by 1000. How to convert a fraction to decimal? We have to count number of zeros, right? Count how many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3 zeros. So, where we must keep point. See, as we have 3 zeros, 3 digits before point. So, only we have 1 digit. Then take 2 zeros help. Count 1, 2, 3. 3 digits before point. So, 5 by 1000 means 0.005. Is it clear? So, expanded form can be written in two ways. Fractional expansion, decimal expansion. Okay? Now, second question. So, before writing the expanded form, please specify the place values. So, before point, it is whole part or integral part. So, what are the place values? Normal place values like 1, 10, 100. Now, okay? Now, after the point, the place values are tens, hundreds, thousands. Okay? Then, the place values will be 9 in 1's place. So, 9. Place value of 8 is tens. So, 8 by 10. In hundreds place, we have 0, so we can avoid it. And then 8 is in thousands place. So, 8 by 1000. 8 in thousands place means 8 by 1000. So, fractional expansion over. Let us write the decimal expansion. We know that in fractional expansion or decimal expansion, whole part never change. So, let us write 9 as it is. So, 9 by 10 can be written as 0.8. Because 1 0 in the denominator, so 1 digit before point. So, it is 0.8. In 8 by 1000, how many zeros are there? 3 zeros. So, 3 digits before point. So, 8 is there. Take 2 more zeros, keep a point. So, 8 by 1000 means 0.008. If we want to write the expanded form, we have to write the place values. So, this is whole part, right? In whole part, what are the place values? 1s, 10s. And in the decimal part, the place values are tens, hundreds, thousands. Right? Now, what is the place value of 9? 90 plus place value of 2? 2 plus place value of 5? 5 by 10. Place value of 4? 4 by 100 because it is in hundreds place. Place value of 3? Thousands means 3 by 1000. Now, shall we write the decimal expansion also? In decimal expansion also, whole part never changed, right? So, 90 plus 2 will be as it is. 5 by 10. What is the decimal form of 5 by 10? 0.5 because 1 digit, 1 0. And what is the decimal form of 4 by 100? 0.04. Because 2 zeros, so 2 digits before point. Okay. What is the decimal form of 3 by 1000? 0.003 because 3 digits in the decimal part, so 3 digits before point. Okay, so fractional and decimal expansions also for this number. Next question, 98.372. Tell me the place values of whole part. Whole part of the place values are 1s, tens, and here 10s, 100s, 1000s. Now tell me the place value of 9. 9 is in 10s place, so 90. 8 is in 1s place, so 8. 3 is in 10s place, so 3 by 10. 7 is in 100s place, so 7 by 100. 2 is in 1000s place, so 2 by 1000. And then decimal expansion. So 90 plus 8 never change, no? Whole part. And these fractions only we have to convert as a decimal. 3 by 10 means 0.3. 7 by 100 is 0.07 because 2 zeros, no? 0.07. 2 by 1000 can be written as 0.002 because 3 zeros. So 3 digits before point. Okay? 0.002. Second Roman. Write the decimal for each of the following. Okay, here expanded form in words it is given. We have to make it a normal number. Okay, see, while making it a normal number, we have to identify till which place value it is in whole part, from which place to which place is decimal part. See children, 6 ones. So this is whole part, 6 in ones place. 6 in ones place. So ones place after, obviously we know decimal point. 6 tenths means 6 in tenths place, and then 2 in hundredths place. See, tenths after hundredths place only, no? So 2, 3 in thousandths. So in thousandths place we must write 3. Okay. Children, while writing any number, if any place is missing, then we have to keep 0 in that place. Okay. Come on. 800s, 3 ones. 800s, 3 ones means in between tens missing. So we will write 8 in tens place 0, ones place 3. So 803 means 803 point. In tens place we have 4, thousands place 2. Tens place 4, thousands place 2. Between them, hundreds place is missing, right? So we have to write 0. So 402. Okay. 402. Okay. See how to read this number? 6.623, right? Wrong. See, the decimal part, we have to read individually each digit. See, like 6.623. You should not read the decimal part as 623. You have to read the decimal part as 623. This number, 803.402. Here, 18 hundredths, 2 in tens, 4 in 1. So, this is whole part. 824 is a whole part. 824 whole part. Whole part after we must keep a point, right? Now, what is there in the decimal part? 8 in thousandths place. Actually, point after first tenths and then hundredths and then thousands. But here, tenths, hundredths, two places missing. So, we have to keep two zeros. For tenths place, hundredths place, two zeros and then 8 in thousandths place. I hope you understood. Third question, children. Convert the following as fraction in the lower term, lowest term, or as a mixed numbers. See, why they have given two options like lowest terms or mixed numbers. See, to convert a decimal number to a fraction, we have two methods are there. First, I will explain both the methods and then which is comfortable, we can follow that. Okay. See, here the first question is 13.72, right? We know how to convert a decimal number to a fraction. First, 13.72. How to write a decimal to a fraction? See, without point, the number is 31372, right? See, when you want to convert a decimal number to a fraction, first, whatever number here, without point, you write as the numerator, okay? So, 13.72 becomes 1372 without point, right? Now, you see, in the decimal part, how many digits are there? 1, 2 digits, right? So, in the denominator, 1 after 2 zeros. Okay? Once again, I'm telling how to convert a decimal to a fraction. Without point, write this number as a numerator. And then, check how many digits are there in the decimal part. If we have 2 digits in the decimal part, in the denominator, 1 after 2 zeros, we must write. Okay? This is one method. So, we should not leave like that. After writing it, we have to cancel if there is any cancellation. Okay? Our second method is, see, 13.72. In 13.72, 13 is whole part, right? So, 13 we will write. What is the decimal part? 72. So, 72, in 72, 2 digits are there. So, we can write 72 by 100. Is it clear? So, 13.72 can be written as 1372 by 100. Both methods, the second method will be little comfortable than the first method. Okay. So, I will wipe the first method and let us go with the second method. So, 13.72 can be written as 13. It is whole part and the decimal part will be 72. As we have 2 digits, we have to write by 100. Okay. See, 72 is an even number. 100 is also even number. So, both numbers can be cancelled in 2 times table. Okay. How many times? How to check? In 2 table, if we cancel, in 2 table, 250s are in 2 table 36 times. Okay. Now, again, 36 and 50 cancel in 2 table. So, 2 table 25 times, 2 table 18 times. So, the final answer is 1318 by 25. Is it clear? Next. 2.253. So, how can we convert this as a fraction? In two methods. What is the first method? Whatever we have, we will write as a numerator. 2253 by here 1, 2, 3. 3 digits in the decimal part. So, denominator 1 after 3 zeros. This is one method. Okay. And the second method is here whole part. What is whole part? 2 is whole part. So, write 2 like this. And the decimal part is 253. So, we will write 253 as a numerator by, in the decimal part we have 3 digits, no? So, 1 after 3 zeros we must write. Is it clear? Okay. Here, numerator is odd, denominator is even. So, no cancellation. So, this is the final answer. Okay. Now, 6.0005. So, first I will explain both the methods and then finally we will give only one method. See, how to write this as a fraction without point, 6 after, without point, we have to write everything as a numerator by, you count how many digits in the decimal part, 4 digits in the decimal part, so 1 after 4 zeros. This is one method. And the still easy method is also there, no? The second method is, here whole part is 6. We will write 6. And in the decimal part, what do we have? 0005. 0005 means 5 only, no? So, let us write 5. By, how many digits are there in the decimal part? Count. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 1 after 4 zeros in the denominator. 1 after 4 zeros in the denominator. Okay. Now, if you see 5 and 10,000 cancel in 5 table. How many times? See, both can be cancelled in 5 times table. Let us see how many times. Shall we do division here? Five twos are 10. And then here 3 zeros are there. For the 3 zeros, if we give 3 zeros here, we will get 0. Okay? So, in 5 table, 2000 times. 5 table, how many times? 2000 times is 10,000. In 5 table, how many times is 5? 1 time. So, the final answer is 6 1 by 2000 is the final answer. Okay, children? Next. Next bit is 8.32. So, how to write this in the fractional form? This is whole part. this is decimal part. So whole part becomes the whole part. Decimal part 32. So 32 by 100, because in 32 two digits no. So one after two zeros. Okay. This one there is no whole part. So whole part no need to write. Only decimal part. Decimal part what do we have? 375. How many digits are this? 375, three digits no. So one after three zeros. Okay. Try this one. 3.175. This is whole part. The decimal part what to write? 125 by 1000. Because in 125, three digits are there, no? So one after three zeros. Is it clear? 12th question, children. Here, what is whole part? 17 is whole part. Okay? So 17 whole part. What is decimal part? 250. In 250, how many digits are there? Three digits. So denominator will be one after three zeros. Okay? Now, so converting a decimal to fraction over. After converting, if there is any cancellation, we have to do. See children, here in 250 and 1000, we have zero, no? So we can cancel zero, numerator zero with the denominator zero. Okay? You cancelled one zero in the numerator and denominator means we cancelled in 10 table. How? I will tell you. See here, actually 250 by 1000, right? In 10 table if we cancel, in 10 table 25 times, in 10 table 100 times. In which table we cancelled? In 10 table we cancelled. 10 table 25 times, 10 table 100 times. See, same thing we will get. Numerator 25, denominator 100 is left after cancelling 1 0 in the numerator and denominator. That means if we cancel 1 0 in the numerator and denominator means you cancelled in 10 table. If you cancel 2 zeros in the numerator and denominator means you cancelled in 100 table. That's a technique. Okay? So, the leftover part is 17, 25 by 100. Is it clear? See, we know 25 and 100 cancel in 25 table, right? How many times? 25 table 1s are, 25 table 4s are. So, the final answer is 17, 1 by 4. Okay? See, nicely if you listen, you cannot do the problem, student. The thing is, you have to practice after watching this video. Okay? See, next question. 42.100. What is the whole part? 42 is the whole part. What is the decimal part? 100 is the decimal part. In 100, see, the decimal part becomes the fraction. Whole part will be whole part only. 42 is whole part. So, we will write as it is. In the decimal part, we have 100, no? So, it becomes a fraction. 100 by, in 100, 3 digits. So, 1 after 3 zeros. Okay? Just now, we discussed how to cancel zeros. See here, in numerator and denominator, we can cancel 2 zeros, right? See? 2 zeros, we can cancel with 2 zeros. If you cancel 2 zeros in the numerator and denominator means, you cancelled it in 100 table. Okay? So, what is left? The leftover part is 42. Here, 1 by 10 is left. Is it clear? How easy? It's very easy. Well, if you practice only. Now, 32.04. Whole part is? 32 is whole part. Decimal part is 04 by. In 04, we have two digits. So, one after two zeros. Children here, don't cancel this zero with this zero. That is wrong. 04 means 4 only. Okay? So, we can avoid it. So, 04 can be written as 4. Okay? Now, 4 and 100 can be cancelled in 4 table. How many times? If we cancel in 4 table, 4 table 1 time, 4 table 25 times. Okay? So, the answer is 32, 1 by 25. Is it clear? The last one in this. Okay? What is whole part? 210 is whole part. What is decimal part? 200 is decimal part. So, 210, decimal part is 200. In 200, 3 digits, no? So, it becomes 1, 2, 3. So, 1 after 3 zeros. 200 having 3 digits. So, 1 after we must write 3 zeros. So, this number's decimal form is, sorry, fractional form is 210, then 200 by 1000. say in 200 and 1000 how many zeros are in common? See, here and here we can cancel two zeros, no? If we cancel two zeros in the numerator and denominator, that means cancelled in 100 table. Okay, what is left? 210, 2 by 10. If we observe 2 and 10, again cancel in 2 table. So again we need to cancel in 2 table. How many times? 2 table ones, 2 table fives. So the final answer is 210, 1 by 5. Is it clear? Children, in today's session we learned how to write a decimal numbers expanded form, the fractional form, in the decimal form, and converting a decimal into a fraction, which is very, very important, children. So complete the notes, practice this all. Thank you.